put that one. Okay, so no open one.
Hello, everyone. This is Cody C. from Geek A.D.D. We're about to start round one. We're just getting our squads built right now. At our streaming table, we have Bryant Francis versus David Wong. I'll just give you a quick rundown of the lists right now. Bryant Francis is over on screen left. He's got the Rebel squad. He's got one of my favorite ships, HWK-290, and Roark Garnet is flying it. He's also got Lando in the Falcon with Han crew, and he's also got Arvel Crynyd with Intimidation, which I think is going to be a pretty potent combo that I haven't seen too many people talk about. In second edition, Arvel can boost into collisions, which in first edition, he couldn't really do that, which kind of made his ability really hard to trigger. If you're connecting with him and you're in his arc, he can attack you and you can't shoot back. Additionally, he has this really good upgrade, Intimidation, which will lower your agility as long as you're, if say your friendly ship is overlapped by this enemy ship with Intimidation, your agility value is going to go down. So that pairs really well with Arvel.
With torpedoes, seismic, proton, standard redline, juking.
David, on the other side, he has a, I didn't get too close of a look at that. Give me 1 second. Okay, so no surprise here. David has Redline, which we've all heard about, especially after the Coruscant. Redline made a huge impact on the meta. His wingmen are Whisper and Major Vermeil in TIE Reaper. Reaper has Vader and 000. Whisper has Juke and Collision Detector, and Punisher has its usual complement of upgrades. Got Proton Bombs, Trajectory Simulator, Proton Torpedoes, Seismic Charges, and the Ablative Plating, so he can be resistant to some bomb explosions.
So I think he has no forward arc, he just does the two arcs, right?
Right
just the
now,
bow tie.
Right
just
now,
the bow tie.
Yeah.
Just has a turret, right?
Yeah. Well, no, Roark has, with the Moldy Crow title, I have a 3 forward, and my two, a mobile turret of 2 in the side arc.
Got it. Okay.
And for my ability, I can catch my ships in the, to knock them die 7, I can use either arc.
Got it. Okay.
Good luck.
Hey, good luck.
Starting time now. 11:40. Good luck, everyone. Fly better.
It looks like Ryan just made the announcement. We're going to start right now.
Leave it on there, and then when I decloak, I'll just tune it over.
Can we do for today? Can we do the evade tokens? Or no? That can stay there. Just I understand now. Yeah, but I just need to see the evade tokens.
Of course.
Yeah.
I always put the evade token. I'm just saying for purposes of
cloaking, right. It doesn't pull and it doesn't pull up. Yeah. Okay. Back to that.
All right, like I said, we got the first round underway. Setting dials again for round 2. Looks like David's getting a little more aggressive with his approach, whereas Bryant seems like he's buying his time. His ships are sideways. So we got to watch out for that cloak whisper on the from the flank towards the bottom. Not sure who's are each other's priority targets here. With David, it's really tough because Redline, he's probably the easiest to kill, but if you leave him alone for too long, he's just going to wreck you with his double mods and the bombs he can trajectory simulate all across the board. Whisper, Oh, man, that's always tough for me. Whisper is kind of a trap because you go for her and then she can very easily cloak, get away, and now you're stuck with either you're shooting at her and missing or she just bugs out. So I'm interested to see how these guys adjust their approaches. Cody Baker, do you mind if we pop in the upgrades here real quick, just so our viewers can see the full lists?
Ships. So activation, bomb goes off. I'm going to use Ablative to ignore that one. It takes a shield. Cool. Okay. I have my I7 double tap.
All right, here comes our first combat.
Second shot.
Okay, it looks like a red line just took 2 damage. That's a pretty good evade there, only taking 2 shields off of a red line shot for Lando.
If you call for a judge, please say it loudly and put your hand up in the air to one rise. Thank you.
Ooh, that's interesting. David might have some plans for Whisper here in the next round. Choosing not to recloak. This is going to be a big move here, because if Bryant chooses to turn and engage right in that little spot in the asteroids there, he could be in danger of being right in the arc of Whisper and Vermeil. Redline might be a little too close to use any proton torpedoes or anything like that. However, it's awkward, because that if the Falcon banks to its right, well, there's not really a whole lot of places to go, so I'm interested to see where Bryant takes this. I have a feeling that David here is going to... let's see. I have a feeling he's going to stay here. He's going to hang back and see what happens. As long as he's not too aggressive, he should still get some shots here. Oh, dang. Here comes another seismic. Ooh, I don't know if that's range 1. Okay, so yeah, based on this, once that seismic charge explodes, it's not really a matter of being close to the bomb, it's close to that that asteroid right there. We'll see if Bryant can clear that. I don't know, I thought he could be falling into a trap right now. A little bit of housekeeping here, getting the damage decks cut, organized. See if they actually cut, or if they just tap it. Okay, yeah, they're doing a cut. Actually, wonder if he's in danger of being hit by his own bomb here. Well, no, actually, I keep getting mixed up on that. I keep looking at the bomb token. It's not the bomb token, it's the obstacle. Looks like he's just going to clear it. Okay, David's follow-up shot's going to be on the same target. It seems like, at least, it seems like. We'll see. Good news for Bryant here is once that asteroid gets cleared out, he may actually be in a little bit better of a situation to maybe trigger Arvel's ability. Since that asteroid's not there, he's going to have a little more room to maneuver. I'm still keeping my eye on Whisper, though, in the back. David's got a really, really sweet paint job on her. Can't tell if it's either coming in or coming out. I guess if it's at the back of the ship, it's got to be coming out of cloak. Oh, yeah, here he comes. So he is going to take damage from that. I'm pretty sure that's range one. I think he'll take damage from that seismic going off. Looks like everyone's got the, I guess the rust from the 2.0, myself included. I have not gotten in as many 2.0 matches as I would like. Though I do appreciate David's 1.0, the way he's locking. I'm going to have a really hard time overcoming that. In 2.0, generally you just have you only put down one lock token and the other one is on your ship. In this game, David's doing the old way of putting on a pair of target locks, one on the ship that has it and then its intended target. That Vermeil was so close. Skillfully done. Okay, so we take a shield off of Arvel and a shield off of Lando. Okay, I'm gonna do Vader again, or not again, but so that's two hits before. Oh man, before we even start engaging, that's brutal. Brian's going to follow up, focus fire on the same target as before. Second shot. plinked one through on red line. Oh, we got a crit. Okay, fuel leak on red line. Han was out of, or sorry, Lando actually was out of range. Oh, dang, not good. Not good for Arvel. So we got a disabled power regulator on to Lando.
Now you want you on this place. When they roll, not all the time.
Yeah, I know. But when they roll, they grab and roll.
Follow up shot from Vermeil. Ooh, hit crit. So no more actions for Lando. Okay, looks like Vermeil took a hit. Just one shield, he's still in the game.
Not really.
Yeah, looks like Brian's taking some pretty heavy damage. Not a whole lot of shields left on his ships. David, the other hand, he's got a fuel leak on red line, but Whisper and Vermeil are still going pretty strong. I'm a little worried about how Brian's going to kind of deal with Whisper, especially being on that flank right now. She could very easily get behind the rest of Brian's list. Looks like they have an incorrect listing on Vermeil. Just corrected that right there. Yeah, Vermeil missing one shield. interesting. Looks like David's going to try to trigger his collision detector. That, oh, man, that's such a powerful combo on Whisper, being able to decloak right into an asteroid and then just ignore it. You really only need to do that once or twice a game. Just get that those clutch shots. Oh no. Well, actually, this might not be such a bad position for Arvel. Oh, that's right. He was double-stressed from the double zero. So maybe he'll get lucky. Maybe he'll get a block on Whisper. But that collision detector, though, it really is not all that, not as valuable as it could be in a normal situation. Well, that's actually not completely terrible, given Lando already has the damage sensor array. I mean, I guess that impacts his ability to repair it, but depending on where Whisper and Redline end up, this could be the last round for Lando. At least he will have an opportunity to get off his Initiative 7 double tap. So maybe he can get some last-minute damage in. David's triggering his collision detector. He has one more use of it this game, which, you know, given Whisper's maneuverability, may or may not even need it. And actually, depending on how these dice go, that block on Redline was actually pretty good for Lando. As long as a primary weapon from Redline doesn't do too much damage, Lando could have actually another round of shooting. I think, pretty sure Redline had used both of his torpedoes, but this prevents him from doing a reload action. Okay, here come the shots on the red line. I Oh, triggering intimidation. So just straight up two hits on Redline. Oh, wow. Wow. He just wiped Redline off the board. I take back what I said about Lando surviving. I suppose it's possible Whisper could still hit him pretty good, but wow. That was great. Great for Bryant. I think caught David a little bit off guard. Ooh, here comes another crit on Lando. Stun pilot. Okay, we should have two more remaining on Lando. Ooh, that's actually not so good, as long as he doesn't connect with anything. Vermeil just took some serious damage from the Hawk Shuttle. Man, that's one thing it's exciting. That's one thing I like to see. I like to see Hawk Shuttles doing well. Ooh, looks like I'm putting the wrong values here on Whisper real quick. One second. Looks like Roark just lost both of his shields. Oh, Whisper easily evaded the shot from Arvel. Warning if this, thank you for that correction. Wondering if that stun pilot's gonna trigger here. There's a lot of traffic right here in front of Lando. Yeah, it's actually not.
Turns are red, right?
Yes. Two turns are red.
All the banks face the Nien Numb, okay. And one straight's up the three. No turns.
Basically, quick scoring update. Even though Redline's down, looks like David has a slight edge over Bryant on score. We've got both Arvel and Lando at half points. So Bryant really needs to do some heavy damage here to stay ahead before he loses Lando. This is going to be a critical turn. You can tell the players they're really taking their time. Thinking about all the different options, asking each other about, what maneuvers can you do? We have a user asking about time and around. It's currently 35 minutes. 35 minutes remaining. Man, I am just not... I do not want to be either of these players right now. I'm sitting here all the way across the room, and I can still feel the tension. Like Whisper's keeping her distance. Yeah, looks like we just had a... Oh, okay, we're back. We're back in. We had a slight hiccup there. We got an error message saying that the Twitch machine was unplugged. So it looks like something on Twitch's end. Not us. I just want to point that out. Not us. Looks like we have one of the Mynock Squadron podcast members having a judge call. But that's another game. We won't worry about that. David Wong helping out. Whisper's just kind of have pick of the litter there. I don't believe she could connect on the Hawk shuttle, but, I mean, not like she would want to. Arvel, 2-hole remaining. Lando, 2-hole remaining. Those are some juicy, juicy targets to get some score some MOV.
Cody B here, just reminding you, there's no MOV in this tournament.
If it goes to time, we need to know. Bryant really needs his... PS7 double tap to connect here.
Thank you.
Oh, that's right. His arcs are facing the wrong way. Looks like we got three hits there. That's... Dang. That's it. Meals down too. Gonna have to do some calculations real quick.
No, yeah. Wait. Laser.
Judge.
Hi. Can you check? Can Arvel hit?
Oh, we got James. James is a great judge. It's funny too. James was He was responsible for the 1.0 Punisher meta at Game Empire. He actually won a store championship with double Punishers. It looks like Bryant actually pulled ahead a little bit in this round by taking down Vermeil and Redline. He just squeaked ahead only 5 points. Oh my god. This is so close. It looks like David now, the onus is on him to execute this win. Don't believe it'll be too much of a challenge for him to track down the Hawk shuttle with Whisper, but you know, you got to be real careful with those A-wings, especially being lower PS. He can block Whisper, but then again, you know, Whisper has that ability to cloak, decloak, so that's really hard to lock down. We're feeling this round's going to be a lot of everyone getting their business sorted out, reset, come back around and engage. Minutes remain on the clock.
Yes.
Man, it's all... I'm not going to lie. This is my very first time commentating, and, you know, I'm a little nervous, but when... Oh, man, when a game gets close like this, I am just... I'm a wreck right now.
It's easy to kind of get just caught up into it, watching the game, you know?
Yeah, no, it's tough. That night, I know, I have a bias towards Hawk shuttles. I love them. I'm so happy they got a buff in 2.0. I was hoping for a little more out of Arvel this game, but you know, it's really hard to gauge something like that. So yeah, most of the, I think Arvel's actually, he's lower end of the pilot skills. So when everyone's got a higher initiative than you, it's hard to make those connections, those block shots.
Whisper might just cruise on by on this one.
I don't know. Okay, he's doing looks like a two turn toward the Hawk shuttle. Uh oh. Coming in hot. I think maybe Bryant was going for a block there, but doesn't look like it worked out. All right. Oh dang, here it comes. Got ooh, just two hits. Ooh, dodged it, still in. Okay, yeah, looks like he was hoping for a block and using the turret on the Hawk shuttle to shoot backwards, but Whisper, as she does, dances in and out of fire. For David to win this, it looks like he's either got to smoke a ship or, yeah, as someone pointed out in the stream, just plink Roark, get a few more points, and get out of dodge. It seems like that would be the priority target here. I think David still has his his collision detector still active. I hope Bryant takes that into account. I think he probably could, if Bryant tries to use that rock as cover, it's not gonna help him. Oh, yeah. So bringing up the collision detector here. For those of you who are unfamiliar with how these work together. So he's got two charges on the collision detector. I think he's used up one this game, and he should have one left. So at a key moment, that Whisper can just, hey, I don't care about this asteroid. Got a notification. 17 minutes remaining. 17 minutes left in the round. Whoa. Interesting. Okay. It's like, oh, uh-oh. Oh, man. Oh, man. Okay. What do we got? Double crit. Okay, Whisper is not cloaked. Oh, my God. Oh, you know what? Sorry, I think that was my bad, guys. I think that those two shields just got plinked off of Whisper. Whisper's been, I don't think it had been damaged earlier. That was my bad. So now Whisper is shieldless. Sorry about that. That's a big deal. That's a big deal. We have no more shields left on anybody. Things are getting tense. Everyone's pacing around the table, eyes locked on their dials. As long as David gets one more hit on Roark and does not get plinked again on Whisper, he can pull this through. It's an interesting choice that he did not decide to use his last collision detector charge. It's a rough thing right there, because obviously he did not want to use it right there. While he could have avoided... or maybe, actually, I'm not sure if he did or not. Because I didn't see him roll for damage. But maybe he did use it.
Minutes remaining in round one. Someone please relay that message into the salt mines. Remember, when you win, the winner goes up to D and gives him the match slip. Thank you.
both players sharing single side of the table, trying to get those vantage points. Time is running low for David. Man, I don't even know what to say about this match. I just, my fist is just in my mouth right now. I'm just clenching my white knuckles. This game is so close. Okay, back to dials again.
So if these points are right, David's got to try to chip away on Roark in the last 5 minutes of this match. Huh?
Yeah, either that or he just takes out Arvel. I mean, in the right context, I mean, Arvel only has two hull. But he is in trouble because if he takes one more hit in exchange, then that's going to put Bryant up even further. Interesting. I don't know if I would have done that. I think I maybe would have hung back a little bit, try to guarantee I get a shot, and definitely a modded shot. I hope Bryant trusts his dice.
Thank you.
So how does this new point system get in the heads of the players then, if you think, you know, the points are updated? These were locked in before the tournament started, but unless you have everything written down, it's hard. It's easy to lose track of points destroyed and half points destroyed and everything.
Well, I don't know. I mean, it could be possible at the last possible moment, David just going to turn looking at Bryant and be like, yo, check this out. Is that that's it? Yeah, hit the light. Dang. Looks like Bryant is the winner. I'll go run and talk to him.
Oh my goodness. Oh. Redline is the scariest thing at this event, and I am very glad that he did not land two proton torpedo shots that were at full health. That's what I'm thinking right now. I need to go report my win. Do you guys need me here?
Hello. I know you do need to go report. I know you need to report your win, but yeah. I just wanted to say, what do you think?
He had amazing flying. I want to stress that above all else. That was one of the coolest games I played in X-Wing 2.0. I've been saying for a while that the strength of the game now is that flying, whatever tricks you have, like I have a gimmicky list. This is shenanigans. This is closer to the old weird gimmicks of 1.0. But at the end of the day, it's still flying. I really admired his approach. His whisper came in and was ready to tear things up. The only reason it turned around was that I don't think he knew that my hawk dial had a stop on it, which was, like, once I was behind whisper. In 1.0 and 2.0, if you're behind a phantom, you have a lot of advantage, and with 5 minutes left in the game, I can see why he made the decision he did. Absolutely great game. I'm so excited. Thank you. Thank you for having me at the table.
Yeah, no worries. I'm not going to lie. The whole time, I was like, oh, man, I am a little worried for Bryant.
I was terrified.
Halfway through the game, it just flipped, and the whole time, I'm just like,
don't underestimate the hook.
Oh,
this little
beauty. Love, hot shots.
If you're a Jedi Knight fan, if you like Kyle Katarn, this is, it's great. Redline may be amazing, but put hawks on your list. Put hawks on your list at home. It's a really good ship. I like putting, it needs the title to work, but with just two upgrades, Trick Shot and Moldy Crow, you can get a lot of bang for your buck. Thank you guys so much.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Bryant.
Wow, that whole game, that was amazing. This is why I like X-Wing, and I hope we're going to get 5 more games just as good. Cody C from Geek A.D.D. We're going to get set up for the next match, but stay tuned. Also, don't forget, we also have Gold Squadron Podcast also on Twitch. Be sure to check them out as well. Thanks.